Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Galactic Science with Arturio, Emerys. I want to talk about some of the other things that I've done in the world that I didn't get a chance to focus on in the last episode. I've started to set up the mind chem area. I've got a sorting system set up. And it's the same as the other side. It's using the relocators and standard barrels. For now, I have a decomposer here with relocator pipes that feed into the system. And I've done an awful lot of quests offline, and mostly that's because there are so many videos out there where people kind of focus on the quests. Early game, the quests are important to get to your cobblestone generation and your obsidian generation going. You need those quest rewards to really kind of make that progress. But later in game, it's the quest rewards are less important later in game, so I haven't really been focusing on those. But I know a lot of you people like to see them, so I'll just kind of show you what I've accomplished so far. First quest line, it's all done. I did finally die. When I was exploring one of the lunar dungeons, I died once. So I finished that one, and that one says it's, you know, complete now. The going up in the world, I've actually made quite a bit of progress on this. The oxygen sealer and the airlock, these don't work very well. They're buggy and they're glitchy, and I don't use them, but I do make them for to complete the quests. I made the NASA workbench, the refinery. I have made a refinery because I do plan on going to the moon relatively soon. I have not made a fuel loader yet. I could do that relatively easily. I have made the thermal padding, and I have not made the rockets. But what I have done is I've got a lot of the material that it would take to make those. So there's like the oxygen sealer. You make one and then you get one as a reward. The airlock controller, you make one, you get one as a reward. Again, I'm not going to use them just because they're so buggy. You can't really rely on them as far as I can tell. Material-wise, I've made quite a bit of the various plates here. I didn't mean to do that. But what I really want to do this episode, and once again I'm lagging a little badly, so please forgive me, is I want to make another oxygen setup. I want to get that done and get that over with, and then I can finish the changes to the base there, close off this area, get rid of the rest of the remnants of the observatory, and proceed forward. So we need three things. We need an oxygen collector, which requires these materials. And most of this I should either have or can make. Wow, I really wish I knew what was going on with the lag on this. This is really kind of driving me nuts. It's almost bad enough. It's right on the verge of making the game unplayable. So I've tried to turn everything unnecessary off on my computer. I'm not really sure where this lag is coming from. It's really kind of driving me nuts. So anyway, I will need some compressed steel. I will need some of those. I'm gonna need some tin. Actually, I'm gonna, at one point or another, use pretty much all of this. All right, so let's start with an oxygen collector, which will require a concentrator. This is where I've been dumping the stuff that I got from exploring the dungeon. All this kind of standard stuff. These are from when I died. Somewhere in here, there's the refinery I made. I wanted to show you this. I may have already, I already used it. I got one of these oxygen vents from killing I think it was a zombie. He dropped one of these. I thought that was kind of strange. So, but I need to make a few of those. So we'll take some of this tin here. I'm not sure exactly how many. I think I need three. We'll start with there. Okay. And I think, this is really, really awful. I think the recipe for the fan is, yeah, that's that. And again, I think I need at least three of these. I don't know if the problem I'm having is just purely because this is a wireless mouse or what the issue is. This mouse definitely is quieter than my wired Apple mouse, but there are times, sometimes it's fine, it's not a problem at all, but there are times when I'm playing where the lag is just very, very awful, and this is one of those times where it's pretty bad. Okay, and I need more steel. There are a couple of different ways to make steel. I'm going to use, if I have, do I have, yeah, I've got all this stuff. So I'm going to grab a couple of stacks of iron here. I got these from doing the decomposed quintuple compressed cobblestone. That's where a lot of this material came from. Carbon. I'm going to go over to the synthesizer. I don't need that recipe at the moment. So the recipe for steel, I believe this, yeah, that's the recipe. And that's not bad. I need more than that. You use quite a bit of steel. Just take everything that's in there. And you can make just normal iron this way too. Okay, good. A little over a stack. That's perfect. So let me just show you this. So this is just kind of running. It's tied into the cobblestone production. So it's automatically getting full of getting filled with cobblestone, and it's slowly kind of converting the lower tier of cobblestone into the higher tiers. And let me take out this is probably more than I need. One thing is, I've heard from other people varying results, so it may work for you, it doesn't work for me. On my computer, on my setup, for whatever reason, if I put quadruple or quintuple compressed into this decomposer, it either doesn't decompose or it just disappears. But the triple compressed will produce tremendous amounts of resources here. So if I put a stack in that there, you can see it, it's going down the pipe and it's going to go get sorted. So it's already starting to refill that iron and fairly quickly. So that's actually a pretty good mechanism for producing resources. At some point I will probably automate this. I may hook this up to put a relocator pipe with an export module on it, and then feed that into the system with a filter so that it'll only take the triple compressed out, and that way it'll never produce anything higher than triple compressed, and I'll just feed that directly into a decomposer that is feeding this sorting system. Now, if I just let this run, eventually these barrels will fill up. So eventually these need to get upgraded to the point where they at least have void barrel upgrades. All of them need to have at least void barrel upgrades. But for eventually I'll have these upgraded to the emerald structural upgrades, and then I can start applying the storage upgrades if I want. If I play this world that long, we'll see how long I stick this out. Okay, so where was I? I was making an oxygen collector. I was working on the concentrator. Memory. is awful. All right. Oh, that was why I was doing that. I was making steel. Now I remember where I was. Okay. A little bit of compressed tin in there. And let me just make a couple of steel here, and then I'll just let that run. I need at least four to make the internal component for the oxygen collector. Wow, this lag. And I think a tin can goes there. Yeah, I think that, no, not that. Is it that? Yeah, okay. Okay, so I need more steel. I think I have everything there other than the steel. Yeah, give me that back. A little bit more steel produced. Oxygen collector, a vent, and tin can. So now we have an oxygen collector, need one of those. We need an oxygen compressor. Oh, I have to make another one of these. Okay, that's not too bad. Come on, compressor, run faster. I need steel. I need it faster than you are providing it. Okay. It looks like I may need some compressed tin too. Let's see, a vent. There's another one. Okay. Compressor. I do have bronze on me. Good. And just producing steel right at the rate I need it, apparently. Just a little bit slow. All right, so bronze. Was it aluminum? I think it was aluminum. We'll find out in a second. Okay. Oxygen collector, oxygen compressor. I am going to make an oxygen bubble distributor because why not? I will need more of this. All right, so I need at least two of these. Let's see, there's that. Distributor. Yep, I think I got everything now. Oxygen bubble distributor. And I will need some oxygen pipe. And I will need some aluminum wire, which may be a problem because I don't really have any spare wool. I may have, let me see if I have I have three there. Is there any wool in here? There's not any wool there. Now I could use MindChem to make string, but apparently it's kind of a multi-step thing. I think. Let me look it up real quick. So if I wanted to make wool with mine chem, it's glycine and titanium dioxide, which titanium dioxide isn't bad. You decompose bone meal and you get very, very large amounts of that. But the glycine, I'd have to make the glycine if I went that route. Or if I wanted to do the string, and string is even worse, you have to make you have to make glycine and you have to make serine and alanine. So yeah, you're definitely better off making wool directly. Glycine's not too bad. But that's why I have a tree farm. Or I'm sorry, a string farm. Was for exactly this reason. Let me grab some. Actually, do I have aluminum wire over here? I don't have any there. I don't have any there. I am gonna need a little cobble. And a couple iron. And where is my chisel? Oh, there's a pair of shears right there. Chisel. Oh, and there, even iron. Yeah, I need to get better about putting stuff away when I'm done with it. I'm just kind of throwing it all in a chest. Okay, there's that. So now I need to figure out is where this is gonna go. And over there, there's a gap. Okay. Just trying to make this all nice and neat and symmetrical. So I may not get all of this on camera. I'll get enough of it that you kind of get a sense for how this is going to work. And then I'll do the rest of it off camera because I'm trying to keep the episodes a little shorter. All right, where is my chisels? And I believe I used a huge. The huge cobblestone tiles for border. And this is just kind of to demark where this is all going to go. I think my long-range plan for the up top here is the blast shield will get replaced with truly blast-resistant glass, so that I don't have to worry about that anymore. There probably will be a farm here, but it is probably going to be another wart farm. I think I'm going to try to go the route for producing rocket fuel in as a fuel source. And for that, you need large amounts of nether wart. And where did that? I'm not sure where that went. Disappeared in a blinding puff of smoke. Okay. There. So, like I said, this needs to be three deep. This is where all the leafs are going to go, the leaf blocks. And in kind of a trial and error fashion, I figured out how many you need for an oxygen bubble to work consistently. And my inventory's full. Okay. Let me see what of this I can dump off. I can at least get rid of. Get rid of that. That'll help. Right, and I'm still pretty much full. I did make some leaf blocks earlier. Trying to remember how many this takes to do. That hopefully that'll be enough. So basically, if you make a 9 by 9 area, 3 deep, 9 by 9 by 3, and put your oxygen production equipment in the center of it, that should produce enough oxygen to run an oxygen collector and a bubble distributor, has been my experience. Okay, now power is going to have to come through here from somewhere. So I need to plan for that. Probably right around there. Now this will probably get wired off camera, because I'm going to try to keep the episode short or shorter. Yep, and here we go with the lag again. Man, what is going on here? Okay, now in the very center, I'm going to need a 3 by 3 area for the 3 pieces of equipment and the oxygen pipe and then the cabling that needs to run it. So since power is going to come from there, let's do this first. Let's do the cable first. So where is the center line? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the center line, so power needs to go here. 1, 2, 3. Is that in the middle? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay. So these Galactic Craft Core, I hate the way these are set up. Okay, I think that's right. They're very, very sensitive in bubble distributor. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna have to move that. Okay, so the bubble distributor is going to go there. The compressor I want in the center, or actually, no, I don't. That's the bubble distributor. Ah. All right. I'm losing my own plan. Okay, the bubble distributor I want in the center because if it's not centered on this little structure, it will drive me nuts. And then this one will go here. Okay, good. That's all set up. Sometimes it's kind of hard to figure out exactly where that stuff needs to go so that the pipes connect correctly. The Galactic Craft Core is very, very sensitive to the orientation of things when you place them for the power and the piping. So now, if I just had some aluminum wire, and I'll just run it along this little channel that I'm going to leave here, and a way to interface it with the wire that's already underneath the tree farm, this would be up and running in just a few minutes. But I think what's going to have to happen is, in order to do it, I have to make quite a bit of aluminum wire to wire all this up. My littlest dog is in the background snoring away. She's so cute. My older dog is kind of sitting there wandering around a little bit, looking at me, wondering why I'm not paying attention to them. And then my middle dog is, she's sleeping too, but she's not snoring at the moment. Okay. All right, so I can put these leaf blocks back. And, oh, I've got more than one chisel now. Huh. Now I'm going to go harvest some of this infested leaf blocks to get string, but I got to clear out my inventory first because there isn't room for everything. Okay, that will automatically get put away. Moon dirt. Go in there. The moon rock will go there. And let's put away the rocket making material. I will need the aluminum ingots. I won't need any more of that. I won't need that. Just stick all that stuff in there. That's a bad habit I have. I need to get out of that habit. Now there is aluminum wire here that I could steal, but I don't want to do that until I have a working replacement. It's just kind of me being overly cautious, I guess. But let me see what's under here. Is there, and I know in the other scenario there's stuff that I can make use of. You know what? I may just steal this wire. Because why not? And then I can use this to convert from the one power system to the other, and also it'll be a little bit of an energy buffer there. I don't really need that. I do need that. Oops. And then who knows, maybe I'll make another oxygen bubble down the road, and I'll have another bubble somewhere. Someplace where it serves my purpose to not have to, maybe down in the base I'll do that. Okay, so what did I get out of that? I got 4 energy conduit, which is not a lot. 4 more aluminum wire, which is not going to be enough. It may help a little bit, though. It may help bridge the gap. Yeah, that's not going to be enough. Okay. I did make some extra oxygen tanks because if you're going to go exploring dungeons, it's good to take extra oxygen with you. And then when I died, before I could go recover those tanks, I had to make more. It was a little bit of a pain to do, but I was kind of set up for it. Did I grab all of those? No, they flew all over the place. Okay. All right, so how am I going to do this? How am I going to tie this power in? So I could, I don't really need to do the sealable wire thing. I could do that. And then go like that. Oh, that won't connect. Okay. So this actually needs to go behind this wall, which I hate doing this, but I guess I'm gonna have to. So I'm gonna have to move all of this. Make this a little wider, which I guess is okay. Just like things to be symmetrical wherever possible. I may have enough to do this. Let me see. So now, all right, where is that energy storage module? Okay, if I put that there, will that, did that connect? It did. And the output's over here, which that will work. But I don't have any more aluminum wire. So now I'm back to the problem that I had before. I need to make the aluminum wire. So this episode is going to run a little long, a little longer than I intended, but you'll get to see the final product of all of this. And I'm reasonably certain that that power system underneath the tree farm is sufficient to run both the tree farm and the equipment for producing oxygen. I mean, it's other than the oxygen bubble, the star harvester, which only produces, I think, 20 RF a tick, is enough to run that. So, this ought to work. And then at some point I'll get to Mars and get Desh so I have an alloy smelter and I can start making capacitors. And all of those Stirling generators will get upgraded so they'll produce 80 RF a tick rather than 20. And I've run into this a couple of times before. Sometimes I'm not really sure why when you harvest those leaf blocks to get string like that with the shears, you kind of get stuck on them. And I'm lagging again. All right. So we got some string. Hopefully this will be enough to make, if I can get it to, there we go. This will give me some iron or aluminum wire. Hopefully just enough. Let's try this again. Trying to be very, very slow and deliberate because it's just not really cooperating right now. All right, that'll give me 12. Yeah, there was another piece of wool right there. All right, let's see if that's enough. That. that piece of stone back. And just because I have this stupid thing, let's put that there. It doesn't really have to be there. Fix the road. That. Do I have that? I should, I don't. A few of these left. Oh, those are infested. Oh, no, 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 no. No, that won't work. Ah, shoot. That would really, really stink. Did I infest any of these others? Okay, yeah. I'm not sure what that would do. Oak leaves? Those are oak leaves. These are oak leaves. Let me just look at these again. Oak leaves. I gotta make sure none of these are infested, because that would be a problem. Actually, maybe it wouldn't be a problem. I really don't know if infested leaves will produce oxygen or not. They might. They might not. I don't know. Let's put that away. And there was one other thing I forgot to do. That's the bubble distributor. That's the compressor, so I'm going to need to have access to that. So I'll leave that open for now. And we're going to put a chisel. Oops. There we go. All right, everybody, cross your fingers. Okay, so the output there is right there. Yep, that looks like that'll work. It's just a question of, do I have enough? To fill that into. Alright, now I need a stick. Or can I do that without a stick? No, it's got to be a stick. Fortunately, I have some small amount of wood to spare. There we go. Okay, I need to backfill that. Put that right there. I'll put a piece of cobblestone there in a moment. Ha ha! When I edit this together, I ought to grab a copy of Beethoven's Ode to Glory and have it play right now. Probably not. Not worth enough. It's too much work to do that, I guess. So there, I have an oxygen bubble, which, let's see if this works, because sometimes this does not actually always work. Oh, it's actually working at the moment. Cool. Oxygen bubble, always nice. And it doesn't look too bad. I will do one other thing before I call it an episode. Need a chest. Do I not have any chests? I should have chests. I don't know. I have to make one real quick. And then I need a piece of relocator pipe, which I hope I have. I only need one. I'll need two of these. Oh, look at that. There was more aluminum wire. That wouldn't have been enough to finish anyway. But, so I did need to make more. Okay, so do I have? Yeah, I've got more redstone there because I need more. Do not have enough redstone. That will give me exactly as many as I need. Okay. Can we please be quite quick? Sir, it is but the work of a moment. The final flourish. Sorry, the wife and I watched Love Actually last night. Love that movie. Okay, so that's the bubble distributor centered in this little square so that my OCD won't make my brain explode. And let's see if I can get the top one there and the bottom one. Perfect. Okay, so the way this works is you put your empty tank in, it gets drawn down into the compressor. When it is refilled, it will get popped back up here. So now what I can do, I can go over here, and all this can go bye-bye. The next time you see an episode, this will be gone. I can take these ones here. I don't know what I'm going to do with my old star, but I will worry about what I'm going to do with that later. Fill that up. And I need one more oak leaf. And it's done. Awesome. Very, very awesome. And I am producing so much wood. In game time, I think it's only been maybe 2 hours since I swapped out this barrel in terms of the game running with it, fully upgraded to the diamond level chopper with a one an 11 by 11. Oh, trapped. There we go. I am free. So it produces wood very, very quickly. And that's going to help me down the road when I start using the advanced generators. But for now, I may have to upgrade some barrels or something. But so anyway, that's today's episode. I hope you all enjoyed it. I'm going to do some work off camera. I'm going to get rid of the remnants of the observatory, and I'm going to get myself ready to make the Tier 2 rocket. I'm not going to make the Tier 2 rocket. I'm going to do that on camera, but I'm going to make sure I have all the resources to make the Tier 2 rocket in the off camera time. So this is Arturio Ramirez signing out. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Everybody have a great day.